All right, guys, I hope you're doing really well. Boy, I am a train wreck today because I'm down in St. George, which I love. Usually I've got this table in this room that's missing where I can set the table and a chair right in front of the whiteboard, and the table is gone. So I'm having to get creative with where I put my iPad. So you got light behind me and cool bars in front of me, and all I can do is say, I love you and I'm sorry. Guys, I hope you're kicking butt today. Let's see how many comments we got here. Three comments, and I invited you to put down something you're grateful for. Guys, we got to do better than that. This is a powerful group on this. Take 2 seconds and put something down that you're grateful for, or say good morning or something. I want to get over 100 comments this morning on this thread. And here's why. Because we can do it. I'm trying to look and see how many people we have. There we go. We've got plenty of people to get that, because I'm going to invite everybody to just put something down and throw it out there so that you are engaged and you are participating. Because I'm telling you, nothing is better for you than at this time of the day to get engaged and participating. And look, I'm preaching to the choir because you're here, and I'm so grateful for that. Yesterday, I had a really, really cool experience. I'm down here in St. George, and Mr. Brian Burnett, he just got a new car, and it's one of the electric Porsches, four-door Porsche electric. It was so fun and so frightening and fast. It was unbelievable. One of the cool parts is that it's kind of a neat story, at least to me, that, you know, you've got this car that's one of a kind, really. You don't see a lot of these driving around the roads, and they're so new and everything. But I got to tell you, when I showed up to the office this morning at 7:30, whose car was in the parking lot, right? And it was kind of a cool thing to see this drive and be a part of it, this amazing car yesterday. And then to have the opportunity to show up and see one of the only cars in the parking lot be that car. And I just, the first thing I thought of when I saw that is, it's not a coincidence. And I know you guys know that. And so my main purpose in saying that today is to say, great job for showing up, because it's not a coincidence either that that group of you that are participating in this today and showing up are also seeing some of the best success in this company. And if there's anyone on here saying, what about me? Just keep sticking with it. It's awesome. In fact, today I want to talk for just a moment, a couple quick things that I've seen on the Tony Robbins in his Unlimited Power book. I just want to share a couple of quick stories that I think are really, really interesting to me. And then I'm going to put a quick challenge out for us to be able to enjoy for just a few minutes while we're doing Morning Ascent. And again, getting more participation. Let's see how we're doing on our chat here. Yeah, we're getting there. Let's go. All right, so here's the deal. In Tony Robbins' book, Unlimited Power, I think you guys have probably read it. It's right here if you haven't seen it. Unlimited Power, Tony Robbins. One of the cool things he talks about, a study, it's called the 100th Monkey Syndrome. It's in a book called, from Lifetide, from a biologist, Lyle Watson. Basically, this short version of this story is that they took some monkeys on an island and they introduced a new food for them, a new food source. I think it was like sweet potatoes or something. And these were sweet potatoes that were covered in sand. And so the monkeys were hesitant to eat them because they didn't understand it. And it was new and they haven't had to take a food that had any dirt or sand or anything on it, I guess. So essentially what it was is that at some point, one of the monkeys solved the issue and he went and washed the sweet potato by the stream. He said, what was fascinating through all this is that he says there was no way. I'm just going to read directly. He says, once about 100 of the monkeys had acquired this knowledge, so cleaning the food and then eating it, other monkeys had had no contact with them at all. Monkeys even living on other islands began to do the same thing. There was no physical way that they could have interacted with the original monkeys, but somehow the behavior spread. And now Tony Robbins goes on to say, like, this isn't unique. There are a number of situations where people act, he puts it here, they act in remarkable unison. And so he talks about stories of where like one physicist or something gets an idea somewhere and in another country almost at the same time is getting the same ideas. And their bottom line is I don't have an explanation for why this happens, but at some level, it seems like when you tap into some type of ability to create some unison with other people and engage in some success, it's like it's floating in the air or something. I'm not trying to get too crazy on here, but it's like you have to tap in. And once you do that, boy, there's some great things that happen. And again, I think I'm preaching to the choir because that's why you're all here this morning, is to try to create some unity and connect with others. He goes on to tell another cool story about, well, how does this work? You can't tap in, right? You can't tap into that energy or momentum or whatever's going on out there unless you know what you want. I thought that was so interesting. And it makes sense, right? Because you're not just going to tap into anything blindly, or rarely that's the case. And so Tony Robbins goes on to talk about how there was a study done in Yale University back in 1953. They took all of the graduates and they asked them a simple question. And that was if they had a clear, specific goal written down for what they wanted to achieve. So a clear, specific goal and a plan for achieving that goal. 3% of the individuals that they studied had that. So they went back in 1973 and they interviewed all of the survivors again of the 1953 graduating class, and they discovered that the 3% with the written specific goals were worth more in financial terms than the other 97%. Now, interesting thing he notes here, just for whatever it's worth, it measures only the financial development, so nothing else, but the interviewers discovered that the less measurable or even more subjective matters, such as happiness and joy, also seem to be, as their perception, at a superior level with the 3% with the written goals. And Tony Robbins goes on to say, guys, in this statement alone, that is the power of goal setting. There is a power in setting goals and knowing what you want to accomplish. And this morning, I just wanted to give us a quick reminder, something I've done 1,000 times. And guess what? I'm going to do it 1,000 more times because I do this personally. And I believe we should all be doing it, which is establishing what we want. And so this morning, I just thought we could do a quick review of that. Everyone's awake and ready, and it's Friday. And man, you can have such a powerful day today when you start the day knowing exactly what it is that you want. So what I'd like to do is run through the 4 wants that we talked about before. What do you want to buy? What do you want? Where do you want to travel? And how do you want to contribute back? And I'm going to invite everyone to write one thing on each one. We've got plenty of people here, and I know people are probably driving and doing all sorts of other stuff, but that's why I'm saying, boy, we can get 100 comments on here pretty quickly. So I don't know if Dylan is still listening, but what I'd love to see us do, guys, I'd love to see us all take just a moment and be thinking for a moment. What is one thing right now that you would love to buy that you can't buy until your real estate game steps it up, or the way in which you handle your money or save your money or whatever, or until you close that one deal or something? What's something you'd love to buy and that you're willing to share with the group? So there's 30 of us on here. I'd love for everybody to throw something down on the screen. I'll do it too. Dylan, if you're there playing a little music right now for just 1 minute, would be really awesome. If not, guys, I'll just hum and whistle for a minute. Sound good? All right. People are already starting to write. Let's do it, guys. One thing you'd love to buy and you just haven't yet, and you got to pull some stuff together to make it happen. All right. Let's do it. I'm going to give you 1 minute, guys. There we go. There's some music. 1 minute. 1 minute.
I might be better on my own. I hate you blowing up my phone. I wish I never met your ass. Sometimes it be like that, but I'm not myself the night you're gone. There ain't no way I'm moving on. I'm not afraid to need you bad. Sometimes we both like wanna love, we both wanna slide. We both wanna argue until we're both right. You wanna hug, a kiss, you deny. Maybe we're both just out of our mind. And you throw tantrums while I'm twisting up. No medicine is fixing up.
Guys, if you don't know how to do it, just hit that. You what?
Got me thinking I might be better on my own. I hate you blowing up my phone. I wish I never met your ass. Sometimes it be like that, but I'm not myself. The night you're gone, there ain't no way I'm moving on. I'm not.
Okay, Dylan, push pause for just a second.
Sometimes it be like that.
All right, guys, that's looking really good. Thank you. Thank you for sharing. Some of you are putting two, which is awesome. Okay, let's move on to the next one. What is something that you want personally? Something that you want, that you're just wanting to see happen, that you're wanting to have in your life, just something. It's a little maybe less, well, I don't want to say specific's not the right word, but it's less tangible, maybe is the right word to say there. You can get very specific, but maybe less tangible. Be thinking about that. A want is different from something you want to buy. A want can be, I want to be more disciplined. I want to have more money in the bank. I want to be more of an investor. I want business to come easier. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. So what is something that you want? What's something you want in your life? Again, not necessarily a buy, but just something that you want. All right, let's get some music going. You have 1 minute. And let's throw some more comments. Thank you. Let's do it. Something you want. Debt free.
And it sounds just like a song.
House paid off. Time.
I want
yes.
More berries and that summer feeling. It's so wonderful and warm. Breathe me in. Breathe me out. I don't know.
Okay, let's pause for just a second. Wonderful. Love seeing this, guys. I love that you're throwing these out there. Now, let's see. Our next one is travel. Where do you want to travel? What experience do you want to have? And look, I acknowledge completely that everyone's going to have different stages. The thing I would say right at this moment, if you're throwing out like, where do you want to be? If you already have a cruise booked for September to the Bahamas, don't say, I want to go to the Bahamas in September. You're already doing that. Think of something bigger. Now, look, bigger might be, I want to go to Disneyland for a week, or I want to go to Park City, or I want to go to San Francisco. I mean, I don't know what that is. It doesn't matter. No one's judging anyone's location and where they want to go, but it's, you know, definitely just figure out where it is that you want to go and throw it out there. So let's get some music. One more minute here on where you want to travel. Let's do it.
I just want to taste it.
taste like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song. I want your belly and that summer feeling. I don't know if I could ever go without watermelon sugar.
Okay, these are great, guys. Thank you, thank you. Hey, these are fun. I hope you guys are reading everyone's answers. It's fun. Oh, someone said Bora Bora. Brenda Lee, me too. Let's do it. Have you guys ever seen the houses that sit over the water in Bora Bora? They're pretty, it's pretty awesome. Okay, so guys, you're throwing out these great things. So to what end? Well, look. We know some of the stuff that we want here, and we're establishing it, and we're sharing it with others, which is fun. And I just personally, I can't speak for you, but I know for me, I'm more motivated right now than I was 25 minutes ago, because I'm just thinking about what I want. I'm thinking about the cool stuff that I can have. I'm trying to tap into that, and that energy and the motivation and that momentum and unison and all of that good stuff that everyone is working towards. So excellent, guys. This is way cool. And I'm loving reading what you're putting down. Final thing. How do you want to contribute back to others? Who do you want to help? What specific ways do you want to give back? This can sometimes be the easiest and the hardest one to come up with because there's so many opportunities, and also so many of them are so personal. But you guys, love to hear from you on ways in which you want to give back to others. We'll get some music going. Do one more minute. Who do you want to help? How do you want to help them? Let's see. Just 1 minute and let's get some more going. We're about, 60, 70, 75. I think we need everyone to put something down. Let's do it. Get some music going. And guys, how do you want to contribute to others?
Talk. Let's have conversations in the dark. World is sleeping, I'm awake with you. With you. Watch movies that we've both already seen. I ain't even looking at the screen, it's true. I got my eyes on. And you say that you're not worthy. You get hung up on your flaws. But in my eyes, you are perfect as you are. I will never try to change you, change you. I will always want the same you, same you. Swear on everything I pray to that I'm on break. Your heart. I'll be there when you get lonely, lonely. Keep the secrets that you told me, and your love is all you owe me. And I won't break your heart.
Come on, yeah.
Oh, I was trying to step it up. I don't need it. I find out. But yeah, I can see it. Yeah, how you doing?
Good. Oh, sweet. Yeah.
All
right, we'll catch you in a bit. Thanks. Okay, guys, let's. These are great. I see you're all putting them down and thinking about it. So, excellent. It's just way, way cool to see. I'm seeing some really powerful stuff here, and it's super motivating. So keep it rolling. I think we're actually really close to 100. So thanks a ton for participating in that today. So what we did, guys, we talked about something you want to buy, something you want, somewhere you want to travel, and finally, ways in which you want to give back. And I'll tell you, for me, I've always believed, number one, that real estate agents and real estate professionals are entrepreneurs, right? They're entrepreneurs. I've always believed that. And then second, what I believe is most entrepreneurs have in like this innate desire to contribute to others and help others and bless their lives and everyone, really. If you haven't read this book yet, there's a book by a man named Larry H. Miller. Many of you will know him in Utah. For those in California that don't know him, he was the former owner of the Utah Jazz. He passed away several years ago, but he has a book that's called Driven. And that's a great book. And one of the things that he talks about in there, he shares some of the things that he's done over the years to help others. And it's not from an arrogant or cocky or boastful standpoint, but he just shares it. And man, it is motivating to read that and see, wow, what you can do to bless the lives of other people. Now, I'm going to tell another story really quickly. I know we got to roll, but another interesting thing that happened, I once sat down with my team of agents and we were talking about this. And this has been, you know, 7 or 8 years ago. And as we were discussing these things, I'll never forget, one of the people said something to the effect of, you know, when I'm rich, when I've made it, I really hope to help with the homeless people. And it was pretty fascinating that there were two women in the room at the time and more, but maybe 7 or 8 people. And the woman who said, you know, I'd like to help with the homeless one day after I've made it, she was actually doing pretty well. And she had a husband that was doing pretty well and fairly successful. The other woman in the room, not so much. Life was kind of tough for her. And she was a single mother and she was having a bit of a tough go at things. And I'll never forget, she wasn't rude, but she stood up out of her chair and pointed her finger. And she said, "You don't have to be rich to help others. I go every week and I feed soup to the homeless people," something to that effect. And I'll never forget the way that she did that. And it was a great reminder that while there are things out there, guys, that, you know, it's going to require money and stuff to accomplish, there's great things that you could be doing to bless the lives of others right now and in whatever capacity. This happened to be the thing she was passionate about. But I'm sharing that story because I loved it. And again, she wasn't rude or anything, but you could see this single mother that was borrowing money from people just to survive at the time and trying to get a real estate career off the ground. And she's doing excellent now, by the way. But it was cool that she like was so passionate about it that she stands up out of her chair, points her finger. And again, you don't have to have money and be rich to serve others. So guys, remember, if you're looking for opportunities to contribute to the other people in your lives, don't wait. Figure out that thing. And I'm telling you, when you're out serving others and doing great things for others, your life's just going to get better. It seems to be proven over and over again. So guys, thank you so much for engaging today. I know we've done this before and I promise you, I'm going to do it again and again because I love it. I love reading what you're writing down. I love the chance to write down myself. I do this personally in my journal and I'll do 10 of them, 5 short-term, 5 long-term. So please, take some time and write some more, identify some other ones. Thank you for engaging today. We got a ton of comments, which is fun. Always awesome to read what you're saying. And guys, I hope you go out and make it a great day. Do your best to connect these dreams and these goals that you have, the best way of connecting them with the activities that you need to engage in. Remember what we said earlier. I recognize that success comes, right? Think about that. I recognize that success comes. And what does it come from? It comes from consistent actions resulting in, right? The outcomes that we're looking for, predictable outcomes. So think about it. Consistent action resulting in predictable outcomes. Success comes from that. These things that you want, that you wrote down, they will come from consistent actions that result in predictable outcomes. If I were to say to you right now, you must take a listing. You must get a buyer that's a good, strong buyer right now. You'd find a way to figure that out. I know you would. So go make that happen and let's create some of these dreams and stuff that you've written down. Let's bring them to fruition, guys. All right, let's close up with some affirmations and have